Hi, everyone, and welcome to episode 3 of The Wonderful World of Halloween. In this show, we're taking a deep dive into the Disney park's various Halloween offerings found all around the world. In today's episode, I will be discussing the Magic Kingdom's fantastic Halloween stage show, The Hocus Pocus Villains Spelltacular. Let's begin! The history of this show really begins in 2005, when after 10 years of very little, Mickey's Not-So-Scary Halloween Party at the Magic Kingdom received an entirely new stage offering. Villains Mix and Mingle was a show that took place on the Magic Kingdom's castle stage and throughout the hub area. While the show proper took place on the stage, the whole mix and mingle aspect required the villains to enter the crowd to interact with the guests. While this was certainly a fun aspect of the show, it didn't last all that long, but I'll get to that later. Really, this show wasn't all that interesting. The only semi-cool facts about it are that it changed when new villains were added to the canon, it reused the Halloween Loween theme song from Paris as a main theme, and it reused a segment from Tiana's Showboat Jubilee along with some of the props. Other than that, there isn't a whole lot to say about this show. While when it initially premiered, it had a lot of really cool elements, over the following seasons, it slowly got cut down more and more, with the whole mix and mingle aspect being removed entirely in 2014. With the show now a complete and utter mess, Disney made a choice to make a new one, capitalizing on that sweet, sweet 90s nostalgia.
Hocus Pocus.
Into the night!
They love to fly, and it shows.
Good night. Sleep tight. No screaming.
At the first Mickey's Not-So-Scary Halloween Party of 2015, the new Hocus Pocus Villains Spelltacular, get it, opened to a very positive reception. While people debated how good an idea of turning the PG-13 rated movie into an all-inclusive theme park show was, nearly everyone recognized it was a vast improvement from the former Mix and Mingle. Over time, it seems that the show really grew on people, such that it returned in 2016 and beyond. However, unlike other shows in the parks, Disney made the choice to have the actresses playing the three sisters perform their own audio as opposed to a backing track. While other characters in the show merely lip-sync to audio from their respective films, each year the Sanderson sisters have slightly different mannerisms and acting choices due to the turnover of the actresses. And I really like that. It makes this show feel more real and live as opposed to something like Friendship Fair, which is very much a carbon copy of its first performance. Anyway, with this whole pandemic thing going on right now, the show isn't being performed, nor is pretty much any entertainment. Thanks, Bob. Anyway, I think the show will return whenever the Halloween parties come back, but until then, we'll just have to wait and see what happens. With all that said, let's move on to the design segment. To understand this show's genius, I'm going to go scene by scene, analyzing each section of the show. With all that said, let's begin. The show starts with a bolt of lightning flashing on the castle. The narrator then announces the beginning of the show, stating that our world and the magical world are combining for just one night. As this happens, the ensemble enters and begins to perform the song Season of the Wake. As this happens, spooky projections are thrown on the castle, a very simple effect, but a greatly appreciated one. The images on the castle also change throughout the show, coinciding with the appropriate scenes. After this, the ensemble gathers as the Sanderson sisters appear. This moment is super cool. It's so rare that we see these amazing characters in the park, so when it does happen, it's always so amazing. Anyway, Winifred announces that since they are back only for one night, they are going to throw the most villainous Halloween party ever. And I just gotta say that you might want to shoot a little higher. I mean, last time you wanted to come back to life and pretty much take over the world, and now you're just downgrading to a Halloween party? Come on, Winnie, you're better than that. Anyway, while Winifred is expositionizing, Mary distracts her by pointing out that there are children in the audience. Winifred then asks the crowd what year it is, to which the sisters do some quick math and shout out the corresponding period it's been since their last appearance. After this, Sarah sings her hypnotism song because, who knows?
Well done, Sarah. I knew I kept you around for a reason.
What reason? What did she do? Begin the party planning? Anyone could have done that. Anyway, Winnie the Shrew then asked Mary and Sarah to present her the spell for her Hocus Pocus party potion. And after some inevitable shenanigans, they eventually discover that Mary's been using it as a candy wrapper for some reason. The sisters then rush over to the cauldron to begin to cast the spell, only to discover that the first ingredient is something they do not possess. Sinister shadows. Dr. Facilier then emerges and begins to sing Friends on the Other Side as the sisters flirt with the Shadow Man. As he sings, stuff explodes, people are shocked, and overall he does a really great job. Honestly, Keith David could make an Olive Garden menu sound enticing.
And now, This is a man that knows how to marry his cousin.
One really cool detail about the segment is a bit later on, when Facilier introduces the inevitable tarot card, the ensemble presents oversized hand props, which happen to be the same ones from the defunct Tiana's Showboat Jubilee from 2009. Anyway, after the sinister shadows are added to the potion, the sisters move on to the next ingredient, which is unfortunately obscured by smudged chocolate. As Winifred gets more and more annoyed, the sisters attempt to hold a calming circle, but to quote Doug Walker...
No, even the movie gave up halfway on that one.
Anyway, the next ingredient is revealed to be nefarious nightmares, as terrifying as the shadow of the moon at night, filling your dreams to the brim with fright. After a knock at the door, Oogie Boogie emerges. The Sanderson sisters, thoroughly unimpressed by this sack of bugs, ask him why he could be helpful. He then tells them that he's their worst nightmares, to which they respond...
We just have nightmares! We call them nightmares!
Oogie then bursts into his song. Not a favorite of mine, but it's still a pretty fun number. This goes on for a while, actually, before it ends and the sisters move on to the next ingredient.
Let me see that.
Winnie then reminds the sisters that unfortunately, they don't have any friends. But right at their hour of need, Maleficent emerges in a burst of green flame. She states that she is quite upset that there was another party that she wasn't invited to, paying tribute to Dream Along with Mickey, where similar exclusions apply. The sisters then humbly beg Maleficent to help them, and she obliges, summoning some of Disney's most famous villains. After they all arrive, Winifred asks for the last ingredient.
The hair of an innocent.
Not going anywhere near that one. Nope. See, this is the problem with adapting a PG-13 movie into a G-rated stage show. You have to cut the raunchy stuff and in some cases put bizarre things in its place.
See what happens when you find a stranger in the Alps?
Anyway, with an explosion, the potion is complete. After which, Mary asks what to do with the audience, to which Winnie responds,
Leave our not-so-sketty friends to me.
And all the powers of my imagination!
No, that's not it. Though, that would be incredible. Anyway, Winifred begins to sing the most famous song from the movie, I Put a Spell on You, and apparently the spell caused Pyro to be shot off the stage. Cool trick, I guess. Anyway, as the number builds in anticipation, it all leads to a big grand finale with a massive Pyro. After this, the villains begin to exit as the sisters thank them for coming, after which my personal favorite interaction in the whole show takes place just before the sisters' final bows.
Sisters, we shall fly! We didn't bring our brooms, we shall walk!
So that's the Hocus Pocus Villains Spelltacular. What do I think of it, you ask? Well, allow me to answer that question in the conclusion. Okay, so here's the thing. This is pretty much my favorite castle stage show of all time, and is also, unfortunately, the only one in the main lineup I haven't seen personally. If that makes me ineligible to judge this show, I don't really care. I absolutely love this show. It's so rare that we see Hocus Pocus in the parks, so when we do, it always just feels so much more special. Also, even without the rarity aspects, this show is amazing. The story makes sense, for the most part, the choice of villains is inspired, and the show overall is just really well done. Also, unlike many other shows from the park, the main characters in this one actually give live performances and are not actors lip-syncing to a pre-existing soundtrack. As an official musical theater nerd, I give a lot of extra points for that. Every year, I always look forward to seeing what the most recent trio of actresses are going to bring to these characters, and I never cease to be amazed at the incredible talent Disney hires. And it's not just this show. Live entertainment is what makes the Disney parks what they are, and it's a real shame that the current management does not realize that. In fact, it's quite sickening to me. Words cannot describe how mad I am at the most recent round of company-wide layoffs, especially because how many of said layoffs were from the entertainment division. I cannot discuss a whole lot of this here because I will begin to explode with anger, and that will not be pretty and will likely involve many adult words not suited for this show. If that's something you would like to see in the future for some reason, let me know because I will make that video in a heartbeat. But for now, let's get back to Hocus Pocus. This show is so well done. I find it really admirable that Disney put so much effort into making this show the quality that it is, and I really wish they would continue to put that effort into the new entertainment offerings. Anyway, the Hocus Pocus Villains Spelltacular is an incredible offering that I really hope to see in person one day, and I'm very glad it's part of the Disney Parks World of Halloween Entertainment. Thank you for joining me at the spookiest time of year in this episode of The Wonderful World of Halloween. If you enjoyed it, please consider liking the video and maybe even subscribing to my YouTube channel. There are a lot of other videos coming out real soon you won't want to miss, so be sure to click the bell icon so you get notified when we upload a new video. Have a great, big, beautiful day. And remember, tomorrow is just a dream away.